on the
Boogie
way.
man band coming round the band. Is boogie man band? Is boogie man band?
Greetings, my fellow Fright Fiends, and thanks so much for dropping by the Horror Zone. I hope everyone's doing well. Wanted to say happy 4th of July to everyone. This is going to be airing late on the 4th of July, but I wanted to just reach out and say I hope everyone's having a great 4th. I know this is a very different 4th of July than last year when none of us could really do anything, so I'm looking forward to spending the day with my family, having a barbecue, taking my mind off of all the craziness that's going on in my life with my house and all that stuff. But what today's video is really going to be about is talking about the brand new Netflix series called Fear Street. This is going to be a 3-week series airing on Fridays, beginning this past Friday, which was July the 2nd. The next one will be airing on the 9th, and the 16th will be the final one. And the first one takes place in 1994, the second one will take place in 1978, and the final one will take place in 1666. Of course, this is based on the R.L. Stine novels. R.L. Stine kind of went past me because in terms of, I just really wasn't into the R.L. Stine, like Goosebumps series. He had Fear Street. I wasn't really into those because by that time that those books were becoming popular when I was a kid, I was already reading Stephen King and Robert Bloch and Thomas Harris and things like that. I knew about this show coming out because Christopher Nelson, someone I greatly respect and admire, special makeup effects artist, Oscar-winning makeup effects artist, as well as the one designing the Michael Myers mask for the new Halloween films. On the Thing with Two Heads podcast that he does with Sean Clark, he had talked about that he had been working on this, so I knew that this was coming out. He kept saying, you know, check out the trailer when it comes out and things like that, so I was really excited to see some of the work that he was doing on it. And pretty much what Fear Street Part 1 deals with is, again, it takes place in 1994. It deals with a circle of friends who accidentally encounter the ancient evil responsible for a series of brutal murders that have plagued the town for over 300 years. For cast, you have Keanu Madeira as Dina. You have Olivia Scott Welch as Sam. Benjamin Flores Jr. as Josh. Julia Riewald as Kate. Maya Hawke as Heather. And Fred Hechinger as Simon. The story was written by Kyle Killen, Phil Graziati, Lee Janik, and Lee Janik directed the film. So what did I think of Fear Street 1994, part one of this 3-part series? I actually had a lot of fun with it. At first, it was a little bit jarring because a lot of the shows and series and films that deal with times that I grew up in, like the 80s or the 90s, a lot of times I feel like they overuse certain tropes and certain music. I felt like at the beginning of this film, it was just almost like overwhelming how many like popular 90s songs they were throwing into the film. But as the story started to progress, I really got into it and really got into the characters. I really loved the opening. A lot of this is really playing on Wes Craven's Scream. There's a lot of really cool homages to the original Scream that I don't want to give away. But I really thought that, you know, the movie starts kind of balls to the wall. It was really gory, shocked me in spots. I didn't know how far they were going to go with the gore. It really surprised me, and it was a lot of fun. I think that's the thing that I really took away from it. It was fun. It was something to just sort of sit back and enjoy. And there's a lot of little touches in this film that I was really surprised by. There was like callbacks to things that I remember as a kid, like store names and things like that, that I really was like, it was taken aback. I'm like going, wow, I haven't heard that name in a long time. So that was really, really cool. I thought all of the cast did a terrific job. I was especially impressed with Benjamin Flores Jr., who plays Josh. I'm a big fan of him from the show Your Honor with Bryan Cranston. He was in that. Fred Hechinger, who played Simon, he stole every scene he was in, and I loved his little quips here and there. Just really made me laugh. Also, nice to see Maya Hawke as Heather, even though she doesn't have a huge role in the film. It was really great to see her. Really a big fan of her work as well. And I thought that the killers in this were really good. There were some really creepy moments. I loved how the story all kind of wraps around this legend of this witch. I don't want to give too many more spoilers away because we have 2 more parts coming up. I will be doing reviews of parts 2 and 3. I plan to do the part 2 review this coming Friday after it airs. I will be in my hotel at that point. I won't be here in the Horror Zone. I thought it'd be kind of fun to do that. It will take some, because I have no idea how long I'm going to be at this hotel. So yeah, I will do that review then. But yeah, I had a lot of fun with the Fear Street part 1 from 1994. Really looking forward to see where they go with the story. Really left me on edge, and I'm excited for next Friday. If I had to give this one a rating on my scale, I would give Fear Street 1994 3.5 skulls. Yeah, that is my review of Fear Street 1994. I'm curious if anybody else has checked it out. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments section below. We'd love to hear from everyone. And as always, thanks so much for dropping by the Horror Zone. I hope everyone has a great 4th of July, and I'll talk to you again real soon. Take it easy. Stay scared as always.